Erev Tov Chavrim, I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live. 68 years ago, John F. Kennedy was faced with Russia trying to deploy strategic weapons on the island of Cuba, only 90 miles off the coast of Florida there, the continental United States. And once again, we are faced with another scenario very similar to that of what happened 68 years ago. Only this time, President Trump is no Kennedy, and he has failed the American public. And of course, the American public has not known nor been advised of actually the failure of what took place just south of Florida. The Russians have actually placed the S-400 air defense missile shield and are also planning to deploy the supersonic nuclear missile in Cuba. But as I speak with you now, the S-400 missile defense shield has been placed off the coast here of Florida there. I'm going to take and share with you some interesting information. Kind of bear with me because I'm having to use a different computer as my wife preparing for the conference coming up this weekend, Saturday, Israeli News Live. Check it out, Orlando conference there, John Moore. But at any rate there, this is one article here from the Live Journal in Russian, but I got it translated to English. One friend on our email, Stephen Ben-Nun at Gmail, sent us this link, Veterans Today. This article came out on February the 4th, 2020 about this. And of course, I didn't take Veterans Today as my source. I decided, okay, I need to see, is there some viable truth for this article right here? So I went to the Russian language. Those of you that know my wife, she's not Russian, but she does speak Russian. So we went to the Russian language, and we are seeing articles in Russian already going back about 8 days ago. Russia placed the S-400 in Cuba, our NATO response. This is the article coming out right here. U.S. media in a panic, Russia S-400 air defense system arrived in Cuba's island of freedom. Moreover, this was done so unexpectedly that before the information in the press had not slipped. This here channel, let's see, I think they got channel one there in Russia. I want to see if they actually, if that's, hang on, bit of a problem navigating right now on this different computer here. But anyway, this is the system right there. They're showing in response to the deployment of the American defense systems near the border of Russia, namely in Poland, Romania, and the Baltic states there, Moscow decided to respond in similar ways, sending so far one S-400 battalion to the U.S. similar borders and specifically to Cuba. Of course, military, this is hardly a massive threat to the United States, but a symbolic context is very important. And that's exactly what we're seeing with the president of Russia. Also, this here is called the Fox News of Russia. Again, Patriot Russian and Soviet Union. This was reported on October the 7th. Russia has placed the C-400 in Cuba. Back as early as October the 7th of 2016. That's an old article there. I apologize. It's not the one that I was wanting to look at there. But at any rate, I had several of these articles up. But we are getting those reports, as I said, that indeed it is a fact that the S-400 system is on Cuban soil there. This was on Live Journal. It was also in the Russian language. We've translated it. Caliber and S-400 are already in Cuba. Washington is confused. According to astrobiological concepts, winter is no longer, and the energetic offensive of spring is connected with the control of Mars. Well, that has nothing to do with the S-400 system there. Russia imperceptibility through the Triumph S-400 and caliber cruise missiles to Cuba. Notice at the request of the Cuban government, the Pentagon was bluffed openly and deceitfully maneuvered. Was that the news was spread around the world that Russia was carrying missiles to Venezuela, but the Russian warship unexpectedly for all abruptly headed towards Cuba. The Cuban government did not begin to hide and immediately stated that Russian missiles were deployed on the territory of the country. They could not squeeze anything out of themselves in Washington for days, and it is not yet known what the United States will do in response. Well, it kind of lets us know that the U.S.'s guard is completely down. In fact, there are several things, if you go back and look at these things. This was reported by another, I think this is a Russian article as well. We must place, this was a Russian article. Time was reporting it, but in the Russian language. This is where Sergei Rybakov had already stated that Russia needed to put the S-400 in Cuba back in October 21st of 2018. He was speaking about that then. Over the issue of what was going on in Eastern Europe with the United States putting missiles on their coast there. Now, of course, Veterans Today has also picked up this story. They were the first, as far as I can see, the first American source to pick up what's going on here. And as I said, we have confirmed this at least up to a week and a half before Veterans Today posted it. Russian news is reporting this as well. This old article, old news from Fox here from back in 2019 of June, talks about Russia sending in its warship into Cuba. And from what we can gather thus far, this is when that S-400 was delivered. It was during this time. Listen to the Fox, what they say there.
To the U.S. tonight, Moscow has sent a warship to Cuba and says the U.S. weapons buildup in Europe could spark a repeat of one of the most dangerous conflicts of the Cold War. National Security Correspondent Jennifer Griffin has the story tonight from the Pentagon.
The new state-of-the-art Russian warship received a warm welcome after pulling into Havana Harbor, just 90 miles from Florida, occupying a berth which until a recent travel ban was filled by American tourist cruise ships.
This is a clear show of force by Russia.
Russia's deputy foreign minister warned of a new Cuban missile crisis if the
like
U.S.
I said,
chooses to
President
deploy
Trump
missiles
definitely
back to Europe
not like after- President Kennedy. He certainly is not following in the footsteps of President Kennedy, who stood up against Russia. And of course, Kennedy, though, did try to make more peace with Russia, trying to end the Cold War, wanted to share some secrets with them as well as far as in space, space technology, or actually specifically for UFO technology, the existence of alien life. And of course, he died not long after that particular incident there. But I'm just really surprised that the President of the United States did not, this has not been made public to the people of the United States already. So it's kind of a shock to me, especially in light of the fact so many things have surrounded the President when it comes to Russia and Russiagate and everything else. And yet now we have the air defense system, the S-400 system, just 90 miles off the coast of Florida. And of course, that puts two naval bases where we fly F-16s out of there. We have some 50 F-16s covering southern Florida there that the S-400 can easily take those out at any time. Of course, one battery could easily be taken out as well. But nonetheless, the fact that this has happened, and now we're hearing that Russia is going to deploy a supersonic missile to the Cuban island as well, really begs to make you wonder, where are we at on our defenses here in the United States? Reminds me of the dream I had many years ago where I saw MiGs coming in, dropping bombs on Florida here. And I've always known that Florida would take the first hit by a Russian attack. Anyway, also another thing too, I just want to mention to you real quick, Iowa caucuses, of course, they're a big blunder as it is, but nonetheless, at only 62% reporting earlier today, Buttigieg claiming the victory already. But I don't think you have to anything to fear when it comes to Buttigieg. I got some a very good source there that has let me know he would have a major battle in other battleground key states. But it was not so much surprising when it comes to Iowa. That being said, keep in mind, I had one friend tell me one time that when Buttigieg was even considering running for president, that he would end up being the Antichrist. Well, I don't agree with that. I think he is a good distraction for the Christian, for most Christians to think that he would be. But I don't believe it, not for a moment, because it is a beast system. And when you're here at the conference this coming weekend on Saturday, and don't forget, you definitely want to be at this conference there. We still have tickets left available. You can get them at israelinewslive.org. I will put a link in the description below here for you to be able to get your tickets there. We have tickets available, and I know how it is. The last week before the conference, that's when they go like crazy and they will sell out. So definitely get your tickets. We do have space available. It is at the Embassy Suites by Hilton, right there in Ultimate Springs, Florida. It is a suburb of Orlando. If you live here locally, you want to come, be sure to put a comment in the website. Your comment is not going to appear as of yet. I haven't had a chance to go in there and approve things yet, but if you want to try to come, you can't seem to get your tickets online, you'd like to get them at the door, I am going to reserve about 20 tickets that can be purchased at the door, but I need to get your name that you're going to be there and that you'll be able to claim those tickets there. We did have one sister that wrote my wife that she had a few tickets courtesy for someone that was in serious need. We did have one brother that wrote me about this. I've already reached back out to him, but there may still be one ticket left like that. So if you want to attend, but you don't have the finances, you live here, near here, or something like that, let me know. Leave it in the comment section as well, and we'll see what we can do about that. Or if you happen to, we get a big request. We do normally get about 10 people wanting to come. And you want to sponsor someone, you can't come, you'd like to buy one ticket, two tickets or whatever to help someone out, you can do that as well. And if you want to do that, I wouldn't do it necessarily on the website. Well, I guess you could do it that way, but actually probably better if you just contacted us in the comment section there, and we can tell you how you could just make a donation. It would save actually a little bit of money that way too. So anyway, thank you and God bless you. Thank you for watching. Don't forget, support the broadcast, israelinewslive.org, and of course, our address appears always here at the bottom of the screen. Erev Tov in a world of Ein Shalom. I'm Stephen Ben-Nun with Israeli News Live.